Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to our program. Today we're here with writer, director, producer, and editor Jerry Vasilatos. Jerry, welcome.
Thank you for having me, Vivian.
And Happy New Year as well.
Happy New Year to you and everybody out there.
And today we're gathered here to speak about your Kickstarter campaign and invite the audience to take part to help restore and preserve your first film as director, Solstice, produced in 1984.
Yes, produced in 1994. Well, actually produced in 1992 and 1993. It first broadcast on Lifetime Television in 1994 and had a subsequent airing in 1995.
Mm-hmm. I understand so far you've raised $6,000. And until next Friday, how much do you need?
Well, the campaign is budgeted for $15,000, and it's very tightly budgeted. That's exactly what I'm going to need to do the restoration of the film. So far, miraculously, we've raised $6,000, and I need to raise $9,000 more by Friday to meet the goal and be able to collect the pledge money from the people who are supporting the campaign.
And before we begin speaking about restoration details, can you just give us a brief introduction about the film? And I know it's your first film as a director, produced 22 years ago, and it appeared on Lifetime as its original holiday movie, correct?
Correct, yeah. I produced it 22 years ago when I was 25 years old. I'm very proud of it in that it was an independent film that was shot here entirely on location in Chicago. And it ended up launching Lifetime Television's yearly annual tradition of having an original holiday film associated with their network. Mm-hmm. So what ended up happening was I produced and directed this film, and I had a producer's rep who saw how much money I ended up spending on it and thought it might be something worth taking out to market to get broadcast, because I was originally using this as a calling card as a director to show that I could direct films. So I put the money into it and was planning on putting it in festivals, but and at the time didn't really realize the commercial viability of it. So a producer's representative went and pitched it to, I believe, Showtime, USA, Lifetime. And at that time, Lifetime was looking for an original movie to associate with their network, but they had not commissioned a production company to produce one. So here's my producer's rep, film in hand, ready to go. And Lifetime ended up licensing it, branding it as their original holiday film, and they broadcast it in 1994 and 1995. Mm-hmm. Solstice is the story of a young man on Christmas Eve who is kind of not in the right spirit of the holidays, and he encounters a variety of different characters on his Christmas Eve that help reinstill in him what the real spirit of the holidays are about. So it was somewhat autobiographical in that I had written a script many years prior to 1993 when we shot the film, where I was trying to work out some issues of my own dealing with getting through the holidays. And when I had the resources in 1992, suddenly at my disposal to start production on a film, I decided to go back to that Christmas script that I had written. And I thought, this is something I think and I hope most people can relate to, dealing with a variety of emotions at the holidays and trying to work through that and hopefully coming to the realization of what we focus on at the holidays isn't what we want, but what's actually surrounding us. And that kind of comes at the end of the film in the character's epiphany at the end of the story. So that's pretty much the background of the film.
And how much did the film cost at the time?
The film at the time cost $130,000 to produce. I had suffered a pretty serious accident in 1986. During my summer semester at Columbia College, I fell while boarding a subway train and lost my leg. You can't tell that now because I'm in pretty good shape and I'm here to talk about it, but it ended up resulting in a pretty serious lawsuit with the CTA. And after it settled, I ended up taking a lot of that money to produce my film to try to make my mark as a director and get my career started. I can't quite finance my restoration campaign that way anymore. Some people say movies cost an arm and a leg to produce. Mine just cost a leg.
That's a great way of looking at it.
Yeah, but you know, I tried to make the best of a bad situation. And ultimately, when the film broadcast to millions of households through Lifetime Television, it gained a very loyal following. People watched it the following year. We ended up doing a VHS video release. I ended up...
And the DVD in 2004?
Yeah, I ended up releasing a DVD in 2004 of the film, which was sold on Amazon. We renamed it The Night Before Christmas to make it a little bit easier to find on Amazon and to market the film a little bit better. But it's to me and all of my cast and crew, always going to be known as Solstice, which the film is named Solstice because Christmas takes place within the week of winter solstice, which is the coldest, darkest, seasonally, time of the year. And on an emotional level, a lot of people might find themselves in that place. So that was the logic behind naming the film Solstice, and how seasonally a character is getting through the holiday during the winter solstice, trying to make sense of things.
Mm-hmm. And previously you said you wrote the script because also some personal issues. Did you finally answer those questions?
I did. I was never a big fan of the holidays. And I think that's why I wrote that script. And as I made that film and was surrounded by so many friends, my crew was made up of a lot of Columbia alums, Columbia students, mm-hmm. friends I'd been in school with. We were shooting in snow. We were shooting in blizzards because the story takes place on one Christmas Eve. And there's a scene in the film where it transitions where the character comes out of the Music Box Theater and it's snowed. So we were waiting for inclement weather conditions to shoot. I think we shot 23 days over. We started in November of 1992, and I believe we finished in March of 1993. We were shooting weekends. But to address your question, I ultimately ended up finding my way through what the holiday should be about. I think through the joy of making this film and focusing on community and people coming together and focusing on what you have, not what you don't have. And that really was very
liberating.
It was very apparent to me with all the people who were supporting me and helping me with this project.
Just so we get a better feel of what you're talking about, let's take a quick glimpse of the trailer and then we can discuss in more detail.
Sure.
Although many of us face troubled times these days, we must always try to keep in mind that Christmas is not the holiday where we get what we want, but when we get what we need.
Is there something I could help you find?
Oh. I can't find it myself. I don't think you could help me.
It's Christmas.
Now, regarding the restoration process, what does it involve? Color correction? Can you give us a bit of an insight on that?
A lot of people are asking, why are you raising money to restore a film that's been finished? When this film was made in 1993 and it was presented to Lifetime Television, we did a transfer of the original film negative to what at that time is called 1-inch broadcast tape. That's an analog format. When you're transferring to an analog format for standard definition video, which at the time was suitable because we had tube TVs back then in the 1990s, the film looked great at that time. Since then, I've wanted to be able to give this film a second life, to try to get it streaming on Netflix, Amazon Prime, release it on Blu-ray for people's HD television sets. However, to go back to that 1-inch analog standard definition transfer is horrible because that image does not look right on our modern flat screen TVs. You're talking about a tape image that's 640 by 480, and high definition TV sets are showing pictures that are this big. So when you're blowing up a frame that small, that big, you lose picture quality, clarity. It looks horrible. When I look at the older transfer on a modern TV set, I cringe because I know the film looks so much better. So through some research, I realized I have an opportunity now to go into my original camera negative elements and have them scanned in a 4K process. And what that means is that a computer will scan each frame of that film in a very large frame size, frame by frame. The film will probably look better on high definition sets now than it did when it was originally projected on screens when we showed it in the 1990s, because when you look at old films on your flat screen TVs now, your high definition TV sets, those films are mastered from the original camera negatives that come out of the film vaults of the studios. The studios are doing the same thing I want to do with Solstice. They're going back to the negative. What you're seeing is exactly how that picture came out of the camera in the most pristine format, without the picture degradation that you even saw when you went to see a movie in a theater, where you'd have film prints. You'd probably be watching maybe a second generation film print, which was duped from the negative. The 4K scanning process allows filmmakers to go into their original camera elements and basically present on a high definition television set the greatest picture quality, as well as preserve the negative. The other thing is, this was shot on 16mm, and the negative is still in good shape, but if God forbid something happened to the negative, the film would be gone. So not only am I looking to restore the film for new audiences or old fans of the film, but actually digitally preserve the film, so I've always got it. Mm-hmm. And I also have it now in a format that I can do color correction. I can digitally enhance environmental factors that we didn't have back then. For instance, I mentioned that snow scene earlier. We were using potato flakes in front of the camera to make it look like it was snowing while there was snow on the ground. Now I can digitally add and calibrate and balance the snow so it's consistent from scene to scene. We can remove any dust or specks of dirt from the negative. It really gives me the opportunity to present this in the best possible format now that I could not do in the 1990s, because it was just the dawn of the digital age. We weren't computer scanning films. I cut this film on an old 16mm Steenbeck where I was physically handling the film. I think it was maybe 2 or 3 years after I finished my film that suddenly we had computers to edit films on. So what's exciting to me is the opportunity to revisit my first film and hopefully raise the money to be able to properly present it the way I'd like to audiences who wouldn't see it in the theater, but be able to watch it on their HD television sets at home.
Mm-hmm. And when would the restored Blu-ray edition be out by?
Well, if we end up meeting our goal through Kickstarter, which is Friday, January 22nd, I will have the Blu-rays that all donors will get if they contribute to the campaign out to everyone by Thanksgiving of 2016.
Just in time for the next holiday season.
Exactly. I started this campaign this past Christmas Eve, giving myself a year, knowing that if I could raise the money to do the restoration properly, I could get the Blu-rays of the restoration in people's hands for the next holiday season.
Mm-hmm. And before we close, can you just give our audience the website, how they can support the campaign, and how much money, what's the limit they can donate?
There are several tiers of donor levels. The way Kickstarter works is you pledge whatever amount you wish to. If by January 22nd I've reached my $15,000 goal, which is what I budgeted and what I'm going to need to do this restoration, then all people who've pledged, their credit cards are charged, the money is then given to me and I can begin the restoration. If I don't reach that $15,000 goal by Friday, nobody's pledges are processed, nobody's charged anything, and I don't get anything to do the restoration. So it really is an all or nothing proposition. Presently, I've raised $6,000 towards the restoration, but I need another
nine.
To be able to do it by this Friday. So I was very gratefully asked to appear on the show and share my campaign with everybody. There are different pledge levels for the campaign. For example, you can pledge $30 and you would be receiving a Blu-ray of the restored film by Thanksgiving. If you donate more than $30, I think that the tiers are at then $50, $100, $250. The more you donate, the more donor perks you get. I will be also giving out autographed Blu-rays, copies of the original shooting script, as well as high-quality, frameable fine art prints of the film's key art, which we use to promote the film. The poster was done by an artist friend of mine back in 1992, and it's just a beautiful piece of art. Mm-hmm. And I figured if I could also get that printed for donors, they would have something frameable in large scale format wherever they'd like to display it.
Souvenir.
As a souvenir, yeah. Mm-hmm. I mean, if you like movie poster art, this is not going to be a small print. It's going to be the same size as the original artwork, which is on a big canvas this big. We also have two top level tiers for people who want to pledge. We have four spots left for individual $1,000 donations and one spot left for a $5,000 donation. What those levels get you are the Blu-ray, the script, the fine art prints, as well as a producing or executive producing credit on the Internet Movie Database, as well as a credit on the actual restored version of the film that's going to be on the Blu-ray. So if you are in film production and looking to add to your producing credits, not only will this help us meet our goal much faster, but you also benefit from being able to add that to your credits and also be thanked in the credits of the film through pledging through Kickstarter. The way to pledge on the campaign is to go to the website www.kickstarter.com and just do a keyword search for Solstice, and that will take you to the campaign mm-hmm. page. You've seen the poster in this segment, so the artwork is on the page. Mm-hmm. It'll be very easy to spot. And even if you can't donate $30, even if you can only donate $5, every bit helps. I'm really in a crunch with 5 days left now to meet that deadline, because if it's not met, the goal isn't met, there won't be anything for the restoration. But I'm staying very optimistic, having already raised $6,000, mm-hmm. that hopefully people who watch this and are interested in adding a Christmas movie to their library, or may have seen it mm-hmm. back in the 1990s and wondered whatever happened to it, there's a great opportunity here to preserve it and restore it for new audiences to enjoy mm-hmm. and maybe make it a new Christmas classic if I can present it properly for modern technology.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so go everyone and support Jerry and his first film as a director.
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, Vivian.
Pleasure. Thank you for being with us here today. And before we close, are you preparing anything next? Just give us a bit of a...
Well, I produce here in Chicago. Mm-hmm. I'm actually working on a potential show mm-hmm. that will focus on the entertainment scene here in Chicago. It'll be kind of like an Access Hollywood Entertainment Tonight program, but focused mostly on what's happening here in Chicago. That's kind of pending. I can't say too much about it, but I am working as a producer on that program to kind of get that on track. What else am I working on? Doing some more screenwriting. I'm also marketing a product that I've invented with my father mm-hmm. that you guys have been gracious to talk about in the past, the SandPad, which is a mobility device. And just always looking for projects to stay busy. If I end up raising the money to restore the film, this is going to keep me busy for the next couple months, supervising the transfer and working with the colorists and editors and doing the restoration. So I'm mm-hmm. I'm excited about that as well.
And for your own personal details, if someone wants to get in touch with you, to speak with you, can you just...
Oh, sure. You can reach me at www.nightstar.com, and that's spelled N-I-T-E. Mm-hmm. STAR. That's my production company, Nightstar Productions.
Mm-hmm. Jerry, thank you so much for being with us here today.
Thanks, Vivian.
And we wish you the best of luck on everything.
Appreciate that. Mm-hmm.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for watching. Have a good evening.